Okay, hey. So the internet's a buzzing about who's coming back next week. And let me stop faking. It ain't the internet, it's just us. Okay, just quite frankly, no one lives for RuPaul like we do. So, we are a buzz about who it could be. Now, apparently, now this is going to be, I don't know if this is true or not. It's a spoiler alert, whatever. But apparently, and I've been able to actually sleep the last couple of nights because my inbox has been inundated with emails from all of you. I haven't had a chance to reply to anyone because I'm kind of dealing with the news. But basically, supposedly, there's a, when they do the previews, there's a preview somewhere and people can see who it is. And they say that who's coming back, if you do not want to know who's coming back next week or who is speculated to be coming back next week, then don't watch anymore. Okay, so those of you still here, you obviously want to know who they say. And I'm going by they as in the internet. That is a buzz because RuPaul did not email or me. And if RuPaul did email me, trust and believe I would dedicate a 2-hour video to that email or that tweet or that. Speaking of Twitter, I need to log on to Twitter because I digress. Listen, supposedly it's Carmen coming back next week. Not really too happy about that because I'm obviously biased towards a girl in particular. Carmen doesn't really bother me that much, but I would really prefer if they brought back someone else from a long time ago. That way you can like have some new, fresh blood in the mix. Because quite frankly, you know what's going on. It's the same old, same old. Same girls, same drama. We need something to spice it up. Something to just disintegrate these whole two groups and everything. So they say it's Carmen. I haven't seen said video. I've looked online for about a minute and I went to logo, saw nothing. I looked at the preview for next week's show that come on after I watched Drag Race yesterday. Not Drag Race, the Untucked yesterday. So I looked at the preview of that, didn't see anything, so I don't know. I can't speak on it because, again, Carmen didn't tweet me and tell me, hey, bitch, I'm coming back. So I don't know if it's true. My heart tells me it probably is true. My soul wants to hold out hope that it's going to be Mariah or Phoenix or some other bad bitch. But it's probably gonna be Carmen. And Carmen's a bad bitch in her own result. She is doing her thing. She has a certain segment. But if we get down to the final, what is it? Final four with Raja, Manila, Alexis, and Yara, I kind of see this going as most of the reality TV shows that I watch go, which is straight downhill. Whoever I think should win probably will not win, and they'll give it to someone else. Now, this brings me back to my overall hatred. Not hate. I just don't like the way that Raja is being portrayed, and I don't like the character that she is playing. I don't think Raja or Sultan is actually like he's being portrayed in the show, but then again, he could be. And then again, when he made that comment, I had kind of got, I got used to him and his ways and how catty and the comments were. But when he looked in the camera and said, I'm tired of being the nice one now, and I'm gonna get me, I was like, bitch, when have you ever been nice? You cut up and you read these girls every fucking week trying to be honest, and now you wanna be mean? What have you been doing? You've been mean since episode one. So now you're talking about you're gonna be mean. It's really like, really? Really though, really bitch. I'm just not into her. I'm not. I mean, I'll be honest with you. I've tried to deal with it. I'm just not into her style. Now, a lot of you love her, and a lot of you that love her. It's funny because a lot of you that love her, you email me. You love her so much, you don't understand where this hatred comes from, and the ones that hate her, like me, that dislike her, don't understand why you guys can't see that it's a fucking man in a dress, and for it to be drag superstar. Maybe I'm old school, but I kind of want to see more. I kind of like my drag superstars more girly, and I just don't see that from Raja. Can Raja lip sync? I'm sure. Can Raja perform? Yeah, but is Raja my ideal of a drag superstar? No. But then again, maybe I'm old fashioned. Maybe this is the new wave. Maybe this is where things are going. I don't know. It's just disappointing. So this is kind of video is just purely disappointment because it's probably gonna be Carmen. And I hope they don't bring Carmen back. You know how you watch reality TV shows, they bring back somebody, an episode, and then that next episode they get on, then they get eliminated again. And it's just like, you just wasted my fucking time by bringing this bitch back. I hope she at least lasts an episode or two. But then it's coming down to it. I mean, just think of reality. We're beyond the halfway point. We're at the winner's circle now. Okay, if Carmen comes back and Carmen stays another week, that means Alexis is gonna go. And then once Alexis goes, then that leaves Carmen, Manila, and Yara. That's a toss-up. The only battle is for number two. And in my heart, I would love it to be Yara. I want Yara to win, but something's telling me they're not gonna let Yara win. This is not the year for the Spanish girl. This is not the year for the international drag queen. Probably gonna be season, is it season three? It's probably gonna be season five or six before one of the Puerto Rican or Hispanic girls wins this thing. Because, you know, there are trends. This is just the year to Mean Girl. And Yara's gonna, I mean, see, it's going naturally for that Yara will win, but Raja will probably win. And then it'll be over, and then I'll be disappointed, and then I'll have to think of something nice about Raja. And now I did something I wasn't going to do, which is why I'm like in this solemn mood right now, is because I looked at an email I got from one of my favorites, and I'm going to chop your name up. Please forgive me. I've tried to say your name before, I fucked it up. I'm not even gonna say your name. It starts with A. Afuna is your name backwards. I can't do names. I'm sorry. But you sent me an email months ago and you told me, you know, spoiler alert, they say who won. And I clicked it tonight and I read the article. Now I'm Perez Hilton. Now trust me, this is not CNN or anything. But I read the article and it really depressed me. It really depressed me because I felt like I've just dedicated an hour and a half every Monday night, an hour and a half every week to something that it depressed me. And if it's true what they say about the two people, then I'm doubly depressed. I'm disappointed. I feel let down, and I feel like redemption should come. I feel like starting a let's say class action lawsuit, and I think a bitch will win. And if you want to jump on at me, we can. After season, we can discuss it. We can discuss all the scandals and the everything. But I'm just kind of depressed because I just can't. You know how you know something's going to happen? And you talk yourself into believing, nah, it's not that bad. It can't happen like that. And then it does happen, and you're like, So that's the video. This is this one. Kind of depressed, upset, whatever. Because, you know, I kind of was hoping that Mariah would come back. And trust me, if Mariah walks across that stage again, You know what I think I'm gonna do? Now I'm back. Now I'm excited and I had a great idea. What I'm gonna do is on Monday or whenever I watch the show, which probably be Monday night because I'm excited now, I'm gonna tape live on YouTube my reaction when RuPaul brings that bitch back, whoever it shall be. So if it's Mariah, you're gonna look and you're gonna see a bitch laying out on the ground, rolling around, jumping up and down, celebration, happiness. If it's one of the others, and if they walk Delta, back across that stage, motherfucker. I'm cutting this shit off. I'm not gonna go as far as my friend Mr. True Monet. I'm not gonna stop blogging, you know, doing that shit because, you know, I gotta keep doing it. But I'm gonna be one mad, depressed bitch. I'm a letter writer. I may end up writing RuPaul. And I know it's 2011, bitches don't read mail, but I will put pen to pad and I will write RuPaul. I will write his real name. I will write his lover. I will write his assistant. I'm writing the dog. I'm writing everybody a letter because that shit is uncalled for. They bring her back. I'd rather have Mimi on first back. And bitch, that's saying something because I fucking hate Mimi on first. But I'd rather see her back better than Delta. That's just me. But yeah, I'm going to do a live reaction next week. Thank you guys for listening. Listen to me vent. I did not mean for this to go 11 minutes long. But you know, when a bitch got passion and fire and when I have hatred in my heart for certain individuals on RuPaul Drag Race, things like this happen. So thanks for listening. We're going to do a live, semi-live show. You're just going to see my reaction next week. And share your thoughts. Like, if it is Carmen, are you okay with that? Or is it just me? Or you just feel indifferent. You're just like, meh. Because I'm just like, whatever. But if Mariah walks across that fucking stage, I'm telling you right now, I'm going to go off. Good thing there's no one living below me is all I got to say. Cause I'm going to go the fuck off. So please, Mariah, come back. And follow me on Twitter. Big Gal Review, same as here. Follow me on Twitter. I'm going to try to tweet more to keep everything going. So thanks. And I will make another video after the show next week when we see the bitch that comes back. Bye.